sports infrastructure in any country plays a great role in determining the excellence and predominance of that country at the global arena in sports. It not only helps in producing athletes of an international stature and repute, but it also helps in promoting and encouraging youths to take part in activities that help in the development of a holistic athletic culture in the country. However, if we consider India, the sports infrastructure in our country is relatively underdeveloped. Nevertheless, India has taken great strides in the field of sports with regard to staging major events such as the Under-17 FIFA Football World Cup, the 2010 Commonwealth Games, as well as the Football World Cup and the Cricket World Cup. August 29th every year is celebrated as a National Sports Day in our country to commemorate the birth of Dhyan Chand, a legendary hockey player who brought immense glory to our nation by winning 3 Olympic gold medals. On this occasion, we at Team IndianFolk went around the city of Kolkata asking people about their opinions with regard to major important concerns in this arena of sports.
So what is the first thing which comes to your mind when you hear the term sports infrastructure in India?
The facilities and the various systems that are there in the various sports that are played in India, the management and administration and everything related to that.
In recent times, we are kind of noticing a capitalist wave in talent hunt in sports in India. Like we have Reliance, Jio, Nita Ambani picking up talents in the field of football from school level, college level to the ISL that we watch on. So basically it's a very commercial driven thing that is going on right now, which kind of is subduing the government authorities that are supposed to do the work. Yeah.
So if I were to ask you one essential drawback of sports infrastructure in India, what according to you is it?
I think the main drawback of any kind of sports infrastructure in India is that there's only one sport which is considered to be a primary sport and the others are not really given that space or that platform. And another thing is that women's sport in India is something which needs a serious lookout.
For me, it's kind of a formation of lobby for sports specifically, because whenever we talk about footballers, the first thing that comes to our mind is Northeast and Kerala. Whereas for cricket, it's the Western and Northern zone. So these kind of lobbies which we which cater to a specific particular sport is something I think is a sort of a drawback for sports in India.
Alright, so like we see that there's a Ranji Trophy or let's say an IPL to really pool together the domestic talent for the country in terms of cricket. We also see that there are a number of domestic leagues and national level leagues across India, but they are very sporadic and interspersed in nature in the sense that there are too many of them and sometimes scouting talent becomes really difficult. So what according to you should be the remedy that a football leagues or let's say other marginal sports, let's say a table tennis or an ice hockey or let's say wrestling in India should be given so that India continues to maintain that streak that it has done continuously in Commonwealth Games or the Asian Games?
Actually, you know, maybe there's a kind of grooming going on in all sports which we might not know because there's a comparatively less media coverage for that, because we often read in newspapers that India is getting medals in a lot of sports, but basically what I said before, okay, we only know about the commercial driven sports that are put into limelight. So there, yeah, there are a lot of talents, but obviously for people to watch, you need to bring marquee players and star players. That in a way improves their game as well because they get to play with stars from abroad. But ultimately that's a drawback.
So what is the first thing that comes to your mind when you hear the phrase sports infrastructure in India?
Like sports infrastructure in India, like it's doing good, like nowadays is developing, the infrastructure is developing, like people are getting more opportunities, the younger generation, they're getting like more opportunities, the local people, like Indian sports, like is it's like going up, like nowadays, like people, like the opportunity thing, like nowadays, like people are investing more, the infrastructure is developing like more nowadays. So
of late we've seen that football in India has been growing. But how much do you think it has been growing in comparison to certain other European or let's say South American leagues?
It's growing a lot, like the sports in India compared to other leagues and also is growing a lot because after ISL started, like different teams, like there are teams that are added also, like it started with few teams after that, two other teams were added, like two new teams. So like players are getting opportunities, like more opportunities for the players, you know, to showcase the talent, like the younger generations, like as I said, like. Yes.
So, why do you think that women do not have adequate representation in sports as much as men do? Like, recently we saw Hima Das, you know, she accrued around 5 gold medals for India. So, do you think women should be given more opportunity in this table?
Women should be given more opportunities. Like, now, like, they are given more opportunities, like, now. And, like, they're having different World Cups for women. Women's sports, like, people like they're having more of events and all, like, so yeah, like they should be given more opportunities, like, to showcase their talents, like, so.
So if you would like to ask the Indian government to you know, four sports other than cricket, what would those four sports be for you?
Four sports
other than cricket?
I think football. Okay, football and basketball, because like there are many basketballers, like, in India. Basketball should be given, like, more preference in India. And volleyball, and like, yeah, what else? Hockey,
maybe badminton,
hockey,
national game.
Sport.
Okay, thank you. So we see that cricket has been given a lot of importance in India. So compared to men's cricket, how do you think that women's cricket is growing in India?
Women's cricket is growing. Has seen a rapid growth in the past 2-3 years because of Smriti and Julian Gosain, players like them, and I think that after 5-6 years, women cricket will also be as popular as men's cricket.
So we see that certain sports in India, like, let's say badminton, or let's say hockey, or you can even say wrestling, has won India a lot of gold medals or silver medals or bronze medals in Asian Games or in Commonwealth Games. So how do you think India should keep up this whole streak that has been set by Indian athletes?
There's nothing that we can do. It's up to the athletes that they perform better, they practice, and it's up to them. Like, there's nothing the public can do about it.
No, so don't you think the government should institute certain very important infrastructural measures so that they get the right amount of diet or, let's say, training to really perform at the top level?
That they should, and that is what the government is for. The sports authority of India is built for that purpose only.
So do you think the sports authority of India is functioning properly right now?
To be honest, I'm not a part of this. I really have no clue about it, but by the movies and documents we have seen, I don't think it's up to the mark yet.
Up to the mark yet. So do you think that there have been a lot of sports movies coming out, let's say Mary Kom or let's say Dangal, which, you know, really show these sportsmen in a very nice light. So do you think that that is helping the youth of this country get motivated to perform in sports across the world?
Definitely. It is increasing the awareness about the different sports and about the different achievements that they have got, and which the normal public didn't know about. So yeah, it is definitely motivating the youth.
Okay, we see that sports in India has till now hitherto been really unidimensional in the fact that it is preferred cricket. Yeah. So do you think other sports such as football, badminton, or let's say wrestling should be foregrounded in the whole Indian context?
Yeah, I think so. The thing is that the problem is the coverage. So media doesn't cover everything. So it focuses primarily on cricket. So when the coverage increases, when media covers other sports and all, then I think we have a chance of excelling also in those other sports. So
I believe, I don't think that other sports, people of India are not interested in other sports other and only in cricket, because especially football, but it's just that it hasn't got to the level, the push that it needs to in order to get on an international platform to be recognized. I think that is what lacks in India. Not the interest. People are interested in other sports as well.
Okay. So we see that European countries, or even African countries for that matter, now have a booming infrastructure, brilliant training, brilliant diets, and brilliantly performing athletes, because the number of African players in the European leagues is immense. Yeah. So what do you think India needs to do to get to that level of, performance and the international level, let's say the Olympics?
Yeah. What they can do, what we can do, is improve our infrastructure. I think that is the core problem in this case, our infrastructure. We have to invest a lot in these things. Even we see in the Olympics that suppose like the gymnast Dipa Karmakar and all,
she came fourth.
Yeah, so she came fourth, and that is with infrastructure that is really inferior.
So our athletes have a lot to give, you're saying.
Yes, so, and we have a lot of talent, so to hold
talent
that
needs to be harnessed.
Yes, we have to harness that, we have to like polish that talent. So in that case, we need
some investment in, when it comes to
probably
infrastructure.
An active involvement of government help.
Apart from that, do you think that right now the Indian government is doing enough to, let's say, promote sports like badminton, wrestling, hockey in India as much as it is doing to give cricket the mileage that it is getting?
Obviously not. Not as much as cricket. I think, like sports like kabaddi and badminton, they are having these shows like we see on
pro kabaddi,
the leagues and all. So badminton also, they are inviting players, like the world's best players, to play for in this country. But not as much as cricket till now.
Nothing to add.
Okay, so last question is, what would your suggestion to the government or let's say the sports decision-making authorities be to really foreground Indian sports in the world scenario?
First thing is that we have to increase our budget, sports budget. There was this comparison where like one of the world's best footballers, Neymar, his own salary is almost as the same as our sports budget. So I think that needs to increase, sports budget needs to increase. Then investing in core infrastructure, these things have to come. So basically,
that's it.
That's it.
Okay, thank you.
To sum up, a few of the basic questions that we asked the people that we interviewed today was whether they do believe that sports infrastructure is indeed very well developed in the country. Also with regard to the fact whether they feel that sports in India is unidimensional. And also with regard to the very pertinent question of women's representation in sports. Despite a multitude of opinions, a few important points did surface. Very importantly, sports infrastructure, as said in the outset, is not very well developed in the country. It is very important to notice that the government needs to spend more on the overall development and nurturing of athletes in the country. Also, women are not very well represented in sports. Cricket is also given a major importance in this arena, which people did express a concern about. It is important to note, however, that India has produced athletes of an international repute, such as PV Sindhu, Saina Nehwal, Sania Mirza, MS Dhoni, Sachin Tendulkar, and a host of many others. We also take this opportunity to congratulate and express our pride for PV Sindhu, who recently became the first Indian to be the world champion in badminton by beating Nozomi Okuhara. For more such videos and important social and current issues, please stay tuned to our channel Indian Folk and like our Facebook page and our website indianfolk.com.